Tapan Kumar Sen.
Thank you, Chairman, sir. The two comments at the outset. In 2016, we brought the adapted this insolvency and bankruptcy code. Not even 1 year have passed. Again, we came for an amendment. I don't agree with the perception of Bhupender ji, my friend here, that reflects how government is closely monitoring. No. It reflects an overhaste by the government without a due diligence in handling such a crucial issue, where public assets are being frittered away by the big corporates. How to arrest that situation? I think Insolvency Bankruptcy Code is one of the important legislative instrument. Much more due diligence was required. I don't object to the very purpose that is written in the statement and objects and reasons, that to prohibit the unscrupulous persons being then benefited at the cost of creditors. You want to prevent that, so you have kept a negative list who cannot be a resolution applicant. I think this is the major purpose, and you have put it in section 29A. I think again the point of the absolute absence of due diligence has reflected, and my previous speakers have already detailed it out. I don't like to repeat and waste time. I want to deal on two major issues. Those aspects need to be taken into account, number one, so that while making a negative list, it should not be such that you don't get an appropriate resolution applicant or invite unnecessary litigation in delaying the entire resolution process to the detriment of everybody's interest. And also the money will not go. My main concern on this, it is reeling in my hand, that whole insolvency bankruptcy court procedure in the background of FRDI bill that is already in the domain. This haircut is concerning me very much. The banking and financial institutions' money put in the certain enterprises, and it failed. Banks are not getting back their money. These are all public money. And here, whenever this whole concept of haircut comes, and when I hear and see in the report that haircut goes to the extent of 75% in certain cases, it becomes the whole intention, whole purpose as written here, to prevent the unscrupulous to get benefit at the cost of creditor, the whole purpose, written intention became a total suspect. And I think government must rescue us from such suspicion. That's not the intention. Where remains the question of this prohibiting unscrupulous person when you are so guard keeping it a guarded secret, the list of willful defaulters, whose character has already been defined by the Reserve Bank of India. Definition has already been defined by. If you keep that guarded secret, and at the same time you'll be telling that our purpose is to prevent the willful defaulters, the purpose becomes a suspect. I think that needs to be clarified and clarified, number one. Number two, why should there be an haircut? Why at all should there be an haircut? After all, public money has been taken, public money has come back to the source. For that, who failed, they must be punished. In whatever way, they should be punished. And at the same time, the venture can be again revived and revitalized. That can be altogether a separate exercise. And for that, our country's existing legislative instruments are there. Whole financial system, whole credit system is already there to take care of that aspect. Then cannot come any point of sacrifice on the part of the creditors, mainly the financial institutions. Unless that is ensured, I think the credibility of the whole exercise is put thoroughly at stake. And ultimately, what is written here, that to prohibit the unscrupulous persons being benefited at the cost of creditors, while writing that as objection reasons, the exercise is exactly be in that particular direction.
Please conclude.
In that direction. I think these aspects must be made very clear. If it is not done with an apprehension that if company will close, people will lose job, I think company will continue to be closed and bank will also continue to lose its money and public whose money is in the bank will continue to suffer. This is the pattern the entire economic philosophy is now being developed at the present regime in the context of which the efficacy of this particular legislative instrument has to be understood and accordingly it should be duly amended, duly corrected.
Thank you.
Apprehensions that have been expressed by the expressed by us here. Due corrections are required there and there must be a time bound. And I think this bill itself should ensure, I request Honorable Finance Minister, to ensure a concrete clause prevent any kind of haircut on the part of the banking institutions, financial institutions. They are all public sector institutions. No private institutions are suffering like that. I think that must be ensured. With these few words, I give my observation on this bill. Thank you.
Sir,